Just as not all customers in store are the same, not all sales are the same. If you have a customer who has started a sale but needs to return at a later time the same day, you may want to use a park sale to remember what was in it. Also, if you have a customer who wants to put down a deposit to reserve a product in your store, you can use the layby or layaway function until they come and pick it up and pay off the balance. For customers that regularly purchase products and pay off their balance at an agreed time, you'll use the on-account option as well. We'll take you through how to process each one now. Let's say our customer has come into our store and is looking to buy a shirt. Right before we accept our payment, the customer mentions they may have left their wallet in their car. And instead of clicking pay, we can look up the top and click park sale. We can easily add a note to the sale describing the details. The sale will close, allowing us to complete more sales to other customers in our store. Later on, the customer returns and we can click on sales history. We can find the parked sale and click the continue sale button. All of the details are returned to the sell screen, including products, customer details, and we can complete the payment and the customer can leave your store happy with the service provided. Account sales can also be completed in Vend. Just add the customer and products, then click pay. Within here, you can look towards the bottom and select on account. This will close the sale and the customer is allowed to take the goods at that time. You can then accept the payment at a later date, either in Vend or through an external option such as a bank transfer. Another selling option is layaway, often called layby in other territories. After your customer and products are added, you can use the notes field to include some terms and conditions if your store has any with layby. After clicking pay, we have the option to select layby. Many stores prefer to accept a deposit before this, so adjust the amount to pay and take an initial payment first if you would like to operate this way. After that, you can select layby and the customer receives a receipt showing their deposit and the amount owed before they can collect their items. Every time the customer returns to pay more, just filter your sales history down to the layby entries and continue the sale. Once the entire sale is paid off, the customer can take their goods.